Hello and welcome to the beautiful city of Odense, Denmark's third largest city and a city known globally as the birthplace of Hans Christian Andersen, the poet and famous writer of children's fairy tales. We're here for the Yonex Denmark Open, the ninth event on the 12 tournament MetLife BWF World Superseries. Not only the ninth event, but also the fourth of five premier events, an even higher tier of tournament within the Superseries. And as you can see, at the end of the year, we also have the Superseries finals. And the destination once again this year is Dubai. The Super Series finals, of course, is only for the top eight players and pairs in each of the five disciplines. And you only get points for how you do in the Super Series tournaments throughout the year. Highly successful event in Dubai on the last two occasions. And already the players are looking forward to this year's finals. Well, it is second round action here this afternoon, and we're starting with women's singles and the left-handed Sayaka Sato of Japan. She's up against Pusarla Venkata Sindhu, the Olympic bronze medalist and beaten finalist here last year. Then we've got mixed doubles and Wang and Huang of China up against the Olympic champions Tontowi Akmada and Liliana Nasir. The Indonesian pair, of course, beaten finalists here on the last four occasions. Then we've got men's doubles and a brand new Chinese pair, Fu Haifeng and Zhu Chen. 11 world championship medals between them, not to mention the four Olympic medals as well. They are up against former champions and home favourites, Matthias Bo and Carsten Morgensen. Then we've got mixed doubles and three-time former champions, more home players in Jochen Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen. They're up against Boden Isara and Sawatri Abatrapai. Then we finish with men's singles, and the former world number one, the left-handed Lee Hyun Il of Korea, up against Victor Axelsen, bronze medalist at both the Olympic Games and World Championships. So what a lineup we've got. Well, as far as the women's singles draw is concerned, this is the bottom quarter. Now, you would expect to see more seeds than that, wouldn't you? But sadly, the number two seed, Rachanuk Intanon, the former world champion, had to withdraw. She's injured her left knee, and we all wish her well for a speedy recovery. But of course, that does mean that in this bottom quarter, the only seed left is the player we're about to watch, Pusarla Venkata Sindhu. So the court officials already on court. I'm Jill Clark, delighted to say that once again sitting alongside me as we look forward to this women's singles, Sayaka Sato against Pusarla Venkata Sindhu, the number six seed from India. Steen Petersen, of course, is the former national coach, head coach to the Danish national team, and it must always fill you with pride, Steen, I think, when you come to an event like this and you see the stage and this wonderful old city. And of course, today we've got plenty of Danes involved as well.
We've got plenty of Danes involved, and we can see that in the hall where it's almost full here, so I expect us to have a really, really good late afternoon here in Odense.
Yes, I think many people are especially looking forward to our last match of the day, Victor Axelsen, because of course he was born here in this city, as indeed was one of the men's doubles player, Matthias Bo. So real home interest.
Lots of home interest, and I think it has increased over the last couple of years because, of course, Matthias Bo had a lot of success in the men's doubles, but definitely the results of Victor Axelsen in the men's singles, I mean, tends to be a little bit more attention to a good men's singles player.
But of course, as far as Denmark is concerned, the last time we had Danish winners here at the Denmark Open, you have to go back to 2011, and that was in the mixed doubles with Jochen Fischer and Christina Pedersen. So for 4 years without a title for home players, it's something, a trend that Denmark will be desperately trying to break, that trend and try and get a champion.
World ranked number 12 from Japan.
It's a draw for them, and they desperately want to win. I think there's a chance this year.
Yeah. Well, we'll talk more about that a little later, because here come
and she is facing players the for the second round in the world ranked number 8 from India, Pusarla V. Sindhu.
Sayaka Sato, and here the Olympic silver medalist, Pusarla Venkata Sindhu, better known throughout the whole of India just simply as BV Sindhu. First female athlete from her country in any sport to win an Olympic silver medal. There's been 4 bronze medals by female athletes at Olympic Games, but never a silver. She was the first. My goodness me, hasn't that brought its rewards? She pictured and in demand all over India to make personal appearances, and I'm sure endorsements are lining up as well. But it's a tough old business, sport, because you're only as good as your last performance. And here she is playing her first tournament since her Olympic success, her Olympic silver medal. And certainly we watched her yesterday, Steen. I thought she looked to be moving quite well. We didn't know how much preparation she'd done, but she looked reasonably fit and sharp.
She looked in good shape. Easily disposed of Herping Zhao from China, who won the Japan Open. So that was a really, really good match in the first round here.
Yeah, certainly was. Tall athletes is Pusarla Venkata Sindhu. Both her parents were international volleyball players. So she's... Oh, now the umpire's got his hand up. There's some sort of problem, I think, with the court. But let's carry on and look at the left-hander. She's 25 years of age, enjoying her 9th week in total at a career high of 12. Born in Miyagi in Tohoku region. And the capital of that region is indeed Sindhu. 171, that's about 5'7". Now this is only her 3rd appearance here at the Denmark Open, and she hasn't played here for 5 years. But in her first round match, she played against Natalia Kolruda. Needed 3 games there, 55 minutes to come through strongly in the end. But I've noticed there was quite a few young Danes in the draw and all pushing higher ranked players the full distance. So here, PV Sindhu, the 21-year-old, turned 21 on the 5th of July, born in Secunderabad, just north of Hyderabad, and at a career high of 8. She's up one place in the Super Series standings, which may seem a little odd because she didn't play the last 2 Super Series tournaments. The reason she's gone up is because 2 retired players from China have been removed from the ranking list. But here is the match that Steve was talking about against Herbin Jiao, the left-hander who won the Japan Super Series title, beating her teammate Sun Yu in the final in Tokyo. And that looked pretty comfortable, didn't it? 21-14, 21-19. There was some tremendous rallies. I enjoyed watching that one yesterday. Henrik Boas of Denmark is our umpire for this one. Fabio Beto of Italy is our service judge. And I'm a little surprised that this will be the first meeting between these 2 players. But I guess it's this lady who, having competed in London 2012 at the Olympics, picked up a really horrific injury and underwent surgery for an ankle injury, made her come back, and then damaged her knee, and I understand had to have more surgery. So that's why she's been out for so long. And of course, with Pusarla Venkata Sindhu really coming to the fore in that interim period,
on the right, Pusarla Sindhu, India.
An amazing comeback after 2 such serious injuries, especially with the competition in the Japanese team.
Sayaka Sato, Japan.
Good of Sato to make her way back.
Sayaka Sato to serve. Double. Play.
So the second round women's singles match. last year's beaten finalist, Olympic silver medalist, far side of the court, PV Sindhu. Oh, crikey.
Serves over.
That went down with some force,
one
didn't it?
One lob.
Yes, just going back to those injuries, Steen, I think she's come back looking leaner.
Yeah.
More physically fit, which after a horrendous injury is extraordinary, and that takes after a famous Danish player, Tina Rasmussen, in a bound as she became.
Sets over, one,
after she ruptured her Achilles in 2005, I think it was, at the Sudirman Cup. I thought she came back a better athlete.
Yeah, I think particular case, team decided
over
the night where she ruptured her Achilles that she would come back and she would be even better, and she would be the hardest working pupil in the class. I guess something similar has happened to Sato. I also think that she's come back technically better than before, and incidentally the first injury with the ankle injury happened at the Olympics in a match against Tina Bauer.
Yeah. Won a Super Series. She hasn't won a Super Series.
Three.
Been in a Super Series tournament final. Sato, that was Indonesia back in 2010. Lost out to Saina Nawal, who I understand, after her knee surgery, is starting to practice again this last week, which is great news for all Indian fans. All badminton fans come to that.
Really shows the quality of the setup that they have nowadays in Hyderabad, the Indian Badminton Association, that they are able to produce consecutive medal winners in women's singles.
Oh, that's good.
Serves over.
That's lovely. Took it early.
4-3.
She's certainly a hard worker on court, is Sayaka Sato. Interested though, Steve.
Steps
you
over.
Say that Sato has improved technically. Any specific aspects?
And I can't really put my finger on any specific aspect. I just think that she's a much better player than the one that got injured in 2012 in London.
5-4.
I think she was playing a more ordinary but efficient game back then. I think. She has more choices now from the same amount of pressure in different corners. It's a short one from Sindhu.
Nice.
Six, four. Change.
Yeah, a slight discrepancy between the two players as to whether the shuttle should be changed or not. The umpire agrees with the left-handed Sato. The shuttle is indeed changed.
Serves over. 5. Six.
That's interesting. Body smash.
Yeah.
Clever.
Serves over. 7-5. Over 6-7.
A couple of times that Sindhu already has tried to get out of trouble in that deep forehand corner by playing it cross court, and neither time it's been terribly successful.
No.
Serves over. 8-6.
Yeah, she took it early enough, didn't she? Challenge.
Sayaka's challenge called out. Line judge, wipe the court, please.
Well, Hawkeye on court one, and they're using their tracking system. Oh, caught the line. Great challenge. What a
correction.
Good challenge.
In.
That's exactly it. The situation where it's good to have Hawkeye because
seven,
I can definitely put myself in the place of the linesman, and I have been sitting on that line, I will probably call
seven,
it out as well.
Nine.
Very difficult to judge those small margins.
Serves over. 10-7.
So 3-point advantage for the Olympic silver medalist here at the mid-game interval.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
So Sato's coach, Keda Masuda.
Court, please.
As far as PV Sindhu is concerned. I don't need the dish.
11-8. Play.
Quite a lot of discussion going on. I think that's natural. If you haven't met a player before, then the pre-game material you've got, the video, only involves other players playing that particular opponent. So the first part of the first game, you sort of try to get a feel on how is the opponent playing against me.
Oh. 12-8.
Wide.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to rely on you, Steen, looking down that line, because I can't see that line at all.
I was a little hesitating because I thought maybe that would have been worth a challenge as well. Oi.
Oh.
Serves over.
Gosh, that came off the frame of the racket, didn't it?
Racket on the top of the net.
It's extraordinary.
Nine,
take a look
12.
At this.
It actually gave Sindhu a chance to retrieve it. because had it been hit all clear, then I don't think she would have had a chance, but
yeah,
a little quicker reaction and she might have returned it.
Oh, that's good.
10, 12.
Yeah, I praise the Indian setup in Hyderabad. Might as well praise the Japanese setup even more because, I mean, they have so many good women's singles at the moment. Okuhara, the Olympic bronze medalist, beat her compatriot
11-12.
Minatsu Mitani later on today, and I believe Yamaguchi is still in the tournament.
Well, at least four singles players from Japan in the second rounds.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. Okuhara.
Line jumps unsided. Review, please.
Yeah.
Another challenge.
No, it wasn't a challenge. Undecided, I think, is it? But Sindhu was raising her arm to challenge it, but I think Henrik Boas said that it was undecided and he wanted a review. That's long.
Mm. Out.
So Sindhu doesn't lose a challenge
12,
for that?
No,
four.
No.
No.
And I remember approximately 1.5 years ago, Jill, we discussed Sato compared to Ayaka Takahashi because Sato sort of took the place in the A team in the Japanese women's singles, whereas Ayaka Takahashi was playing Portuguese international whilst Sato was at the Olympic. As we would expect, the Japanese team had a better feel for what was going on than we did.
12.
That Takahashi has been playing recent tournaments, so and she's been playing well too. To qualify for Japan, got to the final stage.
No doubt that they're making a challenge towards the Olympics on home soil in Tokyo.
Yeah. Now, I do like it when that last rally scheme with Sato taking the initiative and playing the attacking shot. I like to see her playing like that. I think sometimes she's a little bit too reactive because she has got good movement despite all the injury problems she's had.
And she can play rallies.
Yeah.
It's just not a good thing to do here against
13,
Sindhu.
14.
Yes, she needs to control the rallies in my opinion. Otherwise, Sindhu will come in with her attacking shots.
Well, that run has come to an end. Six straight points for Sato. It's put a very different feel
six
on
over.
This opening game, isn't it?
Yeah.
15-13.
Quick points.
Mm.
Yeah, well played.
Yeah.
Good deception.
16,
body
13.
Movement, arm movement, racket movement, looks exactly like a clear shot.
Yeah.
And then just in the nick of time, little twist in the grip.
17, 13.
Oh, this is a good spell, isn't it, from the left-hander. 9 of the last 10 points.
That's good.
Yeah.
Excellent.
That's exactly what I mean. She's taking the initiative.
18, 13.
And there is, in the backhand side of PV Sindhu, there's a little weakness there. We saw it in the Olympic final. It's difficult for her to do a lot, but play it straight back. And Sato was there following up.
19, 13.
We saw Marin in the Olympic final exploit the same area.
20, game point, 13.
Well, this is extraordinary, isn't it?
And also perhaps a little sign that even though Sindhu is the Olympic silver medalist, she's still only 21 because she's been allowed to take this
First game,
run of points
won by Sayaka Sato, 21-13.
More experienced, you might pick up.
Yeah, that was perfect, wasn't it? Yeah.
You might pick up on the fact that there was too many points slipping away from you and get the court mopped or something like that.
Yeah. 8-12 down. 13 of the next 14 points to close out the opening game in 15 minutes. Yeah. Coach Madu is going to have a lot of work to do with the player. I wonder if it's all experience, though, Steen. I wonder if part of it is that the mind may not be 100% focused. There's been so much activity and media attention since she went back to India and since the Rio Olympic Games, and whether she's really got her mind 100% focused into the playing side again.
Yeah. That's always a question. I think there's no doubt that she's not all the same level as the Olympics. I don't think any player is.
No.
But I mean, she started out well. I think Sato wisely played a lot more downwards shots in the second part of the first game.
Court one, 20 seconds.
I apologize for talking in
court
over
one,
the game point, but I can see we have a problem with the scoring system in the hall here because it still shows 19-13 for Sato.
Yes, I noticed we had a similar issue ourselves.
Second game.
But hopefully that will be solved. We'll keep you abreast anyway of the score. Don't worry about that.
Play.
Here we go, second game.
Service over, one, love. Ladies.
Yep, the umpire, as we look at this again, has just called both players over and is explaining that the automatic scoring is down and his touchpad is not working, but we're ahead of the game, as you can see. Well, he's calling for the tournament referee because the scoreboard at the back of the court is wrong, but we've got the score right. There we are. That's what's happened. It got stuck at that score. And that's why we
frozen from back.
It's frozen, yes, but our graphics are right.
Yeah, it's correct now, but yes. One love.
Yeah. We shouldn't delay the play for this. We can get IT experts working on that as play continues, I'm quite certain.
Good shot.
Brilliant, isn't it?
Serves over.
Exactly the corner that Sindhu isn't covering that much. Normally it's a very, very difficult shot to put it all the way across there from a bit under pressure.
Notice where she smashed
two.
It
yeah,
towards
the
that.
Body.
Yeah, towards that left hip.
She looks in really good shape, Sayaka Sato, moving quickly on court.
Yeah, she certainly started the year well, didn't she? She reached the final of the Save Modi Grand Prix Gold in Lucknow. Just out to Sanji Hyung in the final there. That's a terrific final, too. It's now in 25 minutes, three games.
Serve's over.
So what is
two, three.
Sindhu got to do here then, Steen? I mean, is it a matter of mind over matter, and you just force yourself because you haven't put in the practice time perhaps that you would have done prior to the Olympics, since the Olympics, and therefore you've just got to somehow mentally find a way.
Yeah, and I think the mental thing is a big part of it. It's also perhaps not putting too much emphasis on the things that you haven't done instead of focusing on what you have done and what you can do, because I mean, just because you take a break, it doesn't mean that everything goes away and you have to start all over again. So, but you need to take a little bit more control of this match, because clearly she can't, at the moment, withstand the attack and the offensive, the great offensive play by Sayaka Sato. So I think Sindhu needs to put pressure on her opponent. I would play a little bit more to the backhand side of the Japanese player if I were the coach, and I would advise her to do that, because I think she's actually done excellent in her forehand. Playing a little bit side to side with pressure on.
When you say play to her backhand side, are you talking about attacking shots or clears?
Clears and flat pushes. Flat clears and pushes to the backhand side that Sato might have a little bit difficulties coming in the correct position to. Not the case here. This good interception by the Japanese girl. Yeah, there it is again.
Six,
if you have the time to launch a power smash toward PV Sindhu's backhand side, you've got to follow up straight at the net, because there's a really good chance that it's going to go there.
Serves over. 5-6.
Oh, that is nice. That is nice.
6-0.
That's where her height becomes such an advantage, isn't it, Steen? Look,
yeah,
the way she can just create that angle.
And it's very difficult for the players that are a little bit shorter. I don't think Sayaka Sato is particularly short, but we've also seen Sung Ji Hyun from Korea, who's got those really, really sharp cross drops and so on. It's really hurting the players with lesser reach than the taller ones. We saw it be very efficient against Somi Okuhara in the semifinal of the Olympics. Sindhu really utilizing her reach and her steepness.
There you are, Steen. That's exactly what you were talking about.
6.
Smash down Sindhu's backhand side.
And follow up.
She was followed up so quickly and looking for the straight one.
And that was the interesting part about the Olympic semifinal, that Okuhara is a bit shorter in height than Sayaka Sato, so her smash is not that damaging. So she couldn't utilize it in the same way as a little bit taller players could,
seven,
and especially Carolina Marin could in the final. And that's so interesting about badminton, that against different players, different areas come into play. And one thing that is a weak point against one player is suddenly a neutral point against another player, and you can perhaps get your own strong points going.
Well played. 8-0.
Olympic World Championships.
Sindhu.
And from Indonesia, 10% run. And Rianne Kagou, 2-0.
8-4.
And the service judge is Jakob Sundberg.
Yeah, definitely
nine,
long.
8. Stop. 10.
Two
eight.
Errors on return of serve in the last 2 points.
Yeah. And I would like to see Sindhu take a little chance at the net there, because when you just made a mistake on the baseline, you're very inclined to play short the next time.
Serves over. Nine.
Service
ten.
Fault there.
Did you see what it was for,
yeah,
Steve?
It was racket pointing, not pointing in a downwards direction.
Yeah. Good spot. That's a good lift.
Yeah.
That was a very, very good lift from the left-hander.
Decisive phase of the match that we're coming into right now.
Interval.
Well, the psychological advantage, as well as the one-point advantage, is with the left-hander. Look how... I love the way she lunges forward. Sato, racket arm outstretched, really desperately trying to take it as early as possible. 27 minutes into the match in total. And just 1 point in it here at the beginning of the second game. What would you be saying to PV Sindhu right now, then, Steen?
20 seconds.
Yeah, first of all, that she needs to cover her backhand side whenever there's a smashing opportunity for Sayaka Sato, and see if she can get it cross at some point
11,
in
10.
Order to make her opponent unsecure. Right now, it's a pretty safe winner combination for Sato.
Play.
And then I would ask her to put pressure on the backhand side of the Japanese player, both with... with long shots and also clears and lobs, but also flat and attacking shots. Net play, I think, would be beneficial for the Indian player to play to the backhand side as well. We often see left-handed players have a little bit better touch on the forehand side at the net compared to right-handed players.
And is there a scientific reason for that, Steen?
I'm not sure that it's completely scientific, but there's a theory that the way the shuttle is constructed and the way the shot is conducted is beneficial to the left-handed players, because they hit the feathers in a better way.
Yeah, because of course that's exactly the same theory applies to an ordinary slice shot for a left-hander and a right-hander. One hits with the feathers as they go
40,
from right
10.
Over left.
Cross a little bit over, yeah.
Yeah, and the other player hits against the line of the feathers, so it does create a different spin. I was just interested to hear your take on that.
But it's theory, and I don't think it has been...
Serves over.
Researched.
11, 14.
And there's another thing. Sometimes when we look at the players, at least when I look at a left-handed player, I think it looks a little bit strange, and the technique and the movements are a little bit different. But in a program that's called QuickTime on a computer, you can actually mirror the screen, so you get to see the left-handed players from a right-handed perspective, and they look exactly right-handed. So I think in particularly that area, it's our eyes that deceives us.
Mm.
That's actually quite fun. So
challenge here.
Pusarla Sindhu challenge called out.
I was just about to say, Steen, she's played exactly that rally as you've been asking her to play. She can't possibly hear you because we're up in the gods of this stadium.
Yeah.
But she was targeting the backhand more.
Yeah.
Oh, it was out.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're not in the best position to see, challenge, are we? We're not right behind the court. We're looking from an angle.
One challenge remaining. Serve's over.
We usually have a little 15, game ourselves, 11. Don't we, Steen, about yeah. whether that was the correct call or not. Well,
we're not really in a position to do well in that particular area.
No, so it's just as well we got Hawkeye.
Yeah, that's well played. That's exactly the thing.
Yeah.
Serve's over.
Quickly move her to the backhand side with pressure on.
12-15.
She's in dire straits right now. PV Sindhu. Once again, Sato came out better from the interval. Good shot.
It's a good rally.
Oh.
Just seems completely missed time now.
Yeah. Good shot.
Oh, it's just long.
Serve is over.
Just long.
16-13.
Yeah, good call, line judge.
Over 14-16.
A little block back to the backhand side of the left hander to play a net shot.
Yeah, and we've seen that a couple of rallies ago that she almost misses the shot. And she has to go deep in her backhand side of the net. Oh, that was lucky for PV Sindhu.
15-16.
To finish the dub now, Sayaka Sato. She's played an excellent match so far. And that's exactly the difference, that when you smash your opponent to the forehand side, it's much easier to make a cross defensive shot. Outside the picture, we can see that there's a lot of advice coming from the Indian coach's bench, or chairs actually, two chairs.
Oh, that's delightful. That is a wonderful shot. We saw one of those in the opening game, didn't we, Steen, where she really opens those shoulders, looks as if she's perhaps in not really behind the shot, looks as if she's going to clear, and then plays that delightful little slice across court.
And it's short of the white line, and that's so important because that requires an extra step from the opponent. And that's in.
Oh, challenge.
Sayaka Sato, challenge called in.
Well, she's already made one challenge this game, and she was wrong on that challenge.
Yeah.
She was wrong. Oh, that's clearly in. That is clearly in.
Yeah, it's a desperate challenge.
Yeah.
Serve's Challenge unsuccessful. No challenge remaining.
So, as the umpire confirms 16, what I play. Just said, that there'll be no challenges left for PV Sindhu this game. And possibly for the match, unless she...
Oh,
little stamp of frustration there, because her opponent 17, is just 2 points 19. Away from a place in the quarter final.
And that's important, that's significant, that she's so mad at herself here. And and if I was Sindhu, I would get a little bit of hope back, because it shows that she really wants to win this match, Sayaka Sato, and she might be a little bit nervous.
Yeah.
Caught wide.
Yep.
No challenge from Sato.
No, that's why. It was definitely out.
Yeah.
It was wide of the sideline. Can't tell from that angle. So 1 point in it. Well, 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 back level. And has she 19, missed the opportunity? Sayaka Sato, 19 all, no question the momentum. He's with the Olympic silver medalist. Is long, you're right, and a match point opportunity now
20, match point
for the left-handed
19.
Sayaka Sato. I know you sounded awfully confident in your voice, Steen, but as a player, Crikey, that wasn't long by much, was it? 20 all, extra points required until there's a clear 2 point winning margin.
What a good net shot.
Good lift too. Wasn't that going out?
No, it was good. I thought it was wide as well, but it wasn't. What a rally.
What intensity. This is brilliant.
So
going wide. What a rally. Played at such a pace, such intensity.
20.
Remarkable. Look at the lift from that tight net shot. That was amazing. 37 shots, the longest rally of the match so far.
20.
Quite possibly the penultimate point. Because once again, for a second time, it's a match point opportunity for Sato. Turn of serve.
And that's one of the things that we saw with Sindhu at the Olympics, that she's not afraid to go for it. She's not afraid to take some chances. And when you are, you're mostly rewarded.
He who dares wins. So, having saved two match points,
22, 21.
PV Sindhu has a game point opportunity to send this to a third and deciding game. the right. It is indeed one game all. Well, what a comeback from Pusarla Venkata Sindhu.
Sindhu, 23-21.
Confirms the umpire. One game all. 40 minutes. And is it opportunities missed as far as Sayaka Sato is concerned? But look at the reaction there from PV Sindhu. One game all in this women's singles match. You're absolutely right, Steen, about spotting that little stamp from the left-hander of frustration.
1916.
Yep.
1916. Well, I mean, at that point, it's not unusual to feel that, hey, I have a good chance now, I really want to win this match, but hey, why shouldn't you? You won the first 21-13, you're up 1916, you've been the better player throughout the match. So, if she loses this match, Sayaka Sato, I know it's a bit harsh, but you could say that she lost a little bit to herself because she wanted it too much. Mm. If she'd wanted it a little bit less and just focused on playing good rallies, I think she would have won in two games.
Yeah, that's fascinating. You know, often people talk to me about who's got the more desire. It's not about the desire, is it? It's about controlling that desire, because as you've so eloquently explained, if you want it too much, it can actually have a detrimental effect on you.
Yeah, exactly. And I don't mind her little outburst as long as she can get back to the flow, the concentrated stage. And there's some players that are really good at it, and some are not so good. It's common to go for a good victory against the Olympic silver medalist. She definitely wants that victory.
So we have a third and deciding game.
One block.
Well, very, very positive start. That opening ready. My PV Sindhu. That's nice, I like that. There's that drop shot again. Yeah, well worked.
Serves over.
In the left-hander.
And you can see what some of the things that are a little bit problematic for Sato at the moment is that she gets the smash to the backhand side of Sayaka Sato, and she gets the follow-up, but she doesn't convert it to a win. So the rally goes on and on.
Mm.
So she's not as clinical in that situation as she would like to be.
Two, one.
Yeah, goodness me, that was a long way out, wasn't it?
Three,
yeah,
one.
Well, I can tell you, I'm not sure we saw that, but there was another little stamp of frustration from the left-hander, and that to me is very telling indeed.
And there's no doubt who's got the momentum in this match right now. It's clearly with
over.
Sindhu.
Two, three.
That is well played, because that's the first time when she's been smashed down her backhand side that Sindhu has played cross court.
Exactly. And Sato is now committing the mistake of being too easy to read, that she's putting it down the backhand side on all the smashes. Once in a while, she could smash cross. It's towards her own forehand side, so she could run immediately. Keep the backhand side open.
Over. 3, 4.
Well, almost on the square here.
Oh, challenge, yeah.
Sala Sindhu, challenge.
Well, I don't know why I'm saying challenge. I can hardly see that back line.
No, neither can I. But,
but sometimes you... Yeah,
this could be one that just touches the line as well. Really difficult to judge.
Yeah.
Well, I have the tape exactly on the baseline from where we're sitting.
Yeah, so exactly.
I had actually no idea.
Yeah, the tape that's... The white tape that goes across the top of the net is exactly equal to the baseline.
Challenge
from
unsuccessful.
Well,
one challenge remaining.
Certainly looked closer than that, didn't it, to being out when we saw on the replay, but.
That movement she's got problems with. Sayaka Sato from a short forehand corner to a long backhand corner. If there's enough pressure on that shot, there's going to be a defensive shot coming back at you. We discussed it yesterday, Joe, about the drift, whether there was any drift here. It's a very, very small stadium, probably the smallest. It is the smallest on the tour, and it's actually normally very, very good playing conditions. But there is, in my opinion, a slight drift, so that Sayaka Sato plays with the drift at the moment.
So just to be clear, Steen, as we're looking down on the court, the shuttle is flying faster towards that far end.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that's put me at my theory to bed, yeah. Hasn't it? Because I wondered if it was going the other way yesterday. But
6-4.
Keita Masuda is looking fairly intense as his players get closer and closer towards the end of a match. He gets nearer and nearer to the edge of his seat. Oh dear, dear me.
7-6.
I think that's her first service error of the match, isn't it?
7-6.
Good shot. Fantastic deceptive drop shots from Sayaka Sato.
That's a brilliantly constructed and well-worked rally by the left-hander.
It's good to have a little glimpse of the net camera here, because then we can see that even though from the master camera it seems like the net shots are spinning really tight every time, that's not always the case.
Yeah. That one's landed in.
7.
Well, for the first time in this deciding game, Sato goes into the lead. Yeah, that was clearly in, wasn't it? You work so hard for a rally, for points, which she's had to do, Sato, and then a return into the net off your opponent's serve. That's the sort of thing that must frustrate you as a coach. I know you're not involved with either of these players and never coached either of them, but, you know, with your coaching hat on, that's probably criminal.
Yeah, but mostly because as a coach, you tend to think that it's linked to the ability to play the next rally as well. Mm. The amount of moaning over a bad shot.
Serves over.
That's not always the case, and I think players should be allowed to get rid of their emotions, whether they're good or bad, and then refocus on the next rally. If you can do that, I think you come across as a very mentally strong player.
It's gone wide.
10-4.
So there'll only be 1 point in it as they change ends in this deciding game, but which player will have that 1 point advantage?
Good shot.
That's a very good shot.
Interval.
There's your answer. It is the left-handed Sayaka Sato. 51 minutes into the match. It could not be closer. There's got to be at least 1 point in it as players change ends, because it's the first player to 11.
Yeah, and exactly, Sato, who we have in the picture here, she's been a little unsatisfied with herself over this last half part of the game. But I mean, she's still in it.
Mm.
She's got as good a chance as Sindhu to win this match. Mm. So,
court 1, 20 seconds.
Really, just about going for
court
it.
Court 1, 20 seconds.
Well, the most watched sporting event during the whole of the Olympic Games in India was Pusarla Venkata Sindhu's women's singles final. 66.5 million people watched that, Steen. Now, how many times is that the population of your home country, where we are now, Denmark?
That's 13 times the population.
Well, there you go. And the most watched 12, sporting events 10. From the Rio Olympics in China was the men's singles final.
Yeah, I heard a statistic yesterday that 6 or 7 out of the 10 most watched events were badminton events.
Wow.
In China.
Yeah. Yeah, I bet that men's singles semi-final had a few viewers too.
Yeah.
Each our way against the then two-time reigning champion. 11.
And actually, the match Lin Dan against Shrikant Kidambi was really high on the list as well.
Yeah. Nice. Sato's doing all the physical work at the moment, isn't she?
Good shot again. Whoa, that's fantastic.
Well, there's a challenge here from Sindhu.
No, there's no way that's out.
I don't think so either, Steen. Look at it. Watch it,
shot.
Watch it, watch it. Ooh,
maybe it's out.
I'm not so sure.
Wow.
Oh.
I just take it back. It was out.
It was out. What a good challenge. What a good challenge. So that could prove vital, couldn't it?
12 all.
Sayaka Sato is capable of. A really stretching PV Sindhu needs to take a long step to reach it.
gets overdone. Tell immediately, can't you, when it left the racket. That's great retrieving. That's amazing.
Yeah, and it was a high quality shot that came back there. It was really tight over the net. What a great match to start the tournament with.
Yeah, I concur. Of effort, is there?
No.
You know, Steve, when we were talking a little earlier about wanting it too much, and you know, you were seeing and describing the outward signs that you saw from this lady. I couldn't help but think back to the 1993 Wimbledon final, Jana Novotná against Steffi Graf, serving at 4-1 up in the deciding set, Novotná 40-30 on her own serve, and she ended up losing because she wanted it so badly that it was detrimental to her performance. So holding nerves, controlling one's desire. Oh, that's a great smash, isn't it? And making it count when it matters.
14.
It's not just about technical ability. Sport is so much more complex.
Yeah. I guess they still have service practice in the Malaysian men's doubles team. Had two match points. Couldn't get a serve past the net on either of them.
Yeah. In Rio. So 15 all. 1 minute shy of the hour mark.
Yeah.
Yeah.
16-15.
Very, very strong attacks from Sindhu here within the last couple of rallies. I feel that she has a little bit an easier task scoring points right now than Sayaka Sato. Of course, she's a little bit nervous as well, Sindhu, but I don't think it harms her. I mean, she's just happy to be on the court yet and still with the chance to go on to the quarterfinals.
This is an important rally, isn't it? Yeah, it's gone long. Well judged.
Serve's over.
So, as the match clock ticks over that hour mark, one game all, 16 all. An hour of brilliant badminton. And the two players still can't be separated.
Play.
Oh, that's a good defensive shot. Good badminton. What a fabulous contest. By much.
Sindhu.
Oh, the umpire's going to warn Sindhu for taking too long. How many times have we seen that?
Yeah, that's
drop
really
shot.
18,
yeah.
17.
Really hurting Sindhu.
One deep in the forehand corner. It's this one. Oh, here we go. This one here. She looks as if she's not quite back behind it again. And I suppose that in a way adds to the deception.
Yeah.
As an opponent, you think she's got to clear it. She's out of position.
Shot.
Good courage from Sindhu to go forward, but my goodness, I thought for a moment that she was in a position she could have played it, just mistimed it.
What a battle we have here.
Yeah.
Again, neck to neck. Of course, Sindhu wants to win this match badly as well. She wants to prove herself that it was not by luck or chance that she won that silver medal.
And of course, she got a lot of points to defend. She was beaten finalist a year ago. And her points for a world ranking from last year's tournament will drop off the ranking list after this event.
Over 19-18.
And here, when it's so close point-wise, I think Sayaka Sato is less likely to think about winning, as we saw in the second game when she was ahead 19-16 and had a presumably healthy lead. Oh,
that's excellent. Yep. Good use of the body smash too.
20.
Well, she had two match point opportunities in the second game, did Sato. And she's got another two now. What a match. What an excellent women's singles. Sayaka Sato converting on her third match point opportunity because two came and went in the second game. And what a remarkable performance when you're so desperately close to winning it in two straight. To have the character and the nerve not to get dispirited by missing those opportunities. Well, terrific play by the left-hander. It's 5 years since she last played this tournament. It's been quite a wait, but it was worth the wait for the left-handed Japanese player. 21-13, 21-23, 21-18 in the deciding game.